The Gaia satellite will be launched from the European Space Agency in French Guiana. More than 15 years of preparation will have gone into the event, while ahead will lie the challenge of gathering information of unprecedented precision on more than a billion stars.
Será el momento de cruzar los dedos, básicamente, y ver que después de tanto tiempo, pues que el lanzamiento es correcto y que Gaia va a parar a la órbita que le corresponde.
A Soyuz Fregat rocket will take the satellite, which weighs over 2,000 kilograms, to a near-Earth orbit. Once the various sections of the rocket have detached and falling into the Atlantic, Gaia will almost fully orbit around the Earth before heading towards its final destination, the Lagrange point L2, located nearly a million miles from the Earth in the opposite direction to the Sun.
Tenemos el Sol, la Tierra, y L2 está 1,5 millones de kilómetros más allá. Desde ese punto, y en la órbita que se ha elegido alrededor de ese punto, la Luna y la Tierra no causan eclipses en Gaia. Y el Sol queda suficientemente alejado, por decirlo de alguna manera. Y entonces Gaia puede operar en un entorno térmico tranquilo.
After the last impulse from the Fregat module, it will take Gaia about 30 days to reach L2. Then, a couple of months will be spent calibrating and verifying the complex measuring instruments whose structure is made of silicon carbide, a very rigid ceramic material that meets the high stability requirements for the satellite. The huge sun shield, which has already become the satellite's trademark, protects Gaia from the sun. Made in Spain, the sun shield measures more than 10 meters in diameter and ensures the interior of the satellite is kept at minus 170 degrees Celsius.
Para funcionar bien, cada parte del instrumento tiene que mantener su temperatura. Una temperatura muy baja, pero lo más importante es que es estable, que no cambie nada.
Gaia will record the positions, distances, motions, and spectra of stars and other objects from the galactic center out to the borders of our galaxy. To do this, it will use two telescopes with 6 mirrors each and the jewel in the crown of the satellite, the focal plane. With almost a billion pixels, it is the largest camera ever built for space. Altogether, this will allow an accuracy of microarcseconds in the measurements.
Gaia lo que mide son pequeños cambios angulares. Lo que está midiendo Gaia es el tamaño de algo así como la pupila del ojo de un hombre que estuviera en la Luna visto desde la Tierra.
The two telescopes will determine not only where each star is, but the three-dimensional position of each star and how they all move through space.
Con los dos telescopios lo que hacemos es medir una estrella en relación a otra estrella muy alejada. La cuestión no son solo los dos telescopios, sino dos telescopios separados mirando a direcciones muy distintas.
Observando al mismo tiempo en estos dos campos y combinando muchísimas observaciones de los dos campos durante meses, podemos cubrir todo el cielo.
Gaia will sweep the sky continuously for 5 years, so that each bright spot will be observed an average of about 80 times. All that information will be recorded via the focal plane, which is 1 meter wide by 42 centimeters high and contains a total of 106 CCDs with 9 megapixels each. To cover the surface, it would take 1,000 sensors from everyday digital cameras. The data recorded will allow us to obtain a huge amount of scientific information.
Además de la información sobre la posición tridimensional y sus movimientos, nos va a proporcionar información, por ejemplo, sobre la composición química de cada estrella. Y esto es bien interesante, porque sabemos que los elementos químicos se forman en grandes nubes moleculares que hay en el espacio, pero la tasa a la cual estas nubes son enriquecidas químicamente nos puede dar información sobre cómo es que la galaxia fue formada.
To achieve this, two prisms disperse the blue and red components of the light received.
La luz se dispersa en colores y la medida de la intensidad en cada uno de los colores es precisamente la que nos proporciona la información de temperaturas, de luminosidades y de contenido metálico.
These parameters reveal the mechanisms of star formation and the properties of the environment where the stars were born. Furthermore, a diffraction grating will allow us to obtain spectra from the bright stars. From the redshift or blue shift observed in these, we can tell the speed at which astronomical objects are moving towards or away from Gaia. All the data will be transmitted to Earth every day, and it is estimated that the resulting database will occupy a petabyte, or a million gigabytes. It will be an extremely valuable resource for astronomers with information about 1 billion stars in our galaxy, 10,000 times more than is available today, and with a precision 100 times better. Gaia will also observe 100,000 supernovas in other galaxies, thousands of extrasolar planets, and hundreds of thousands of objects in the solar system. Overall, the most complete 3D map of our galaxy that has ever been made.